ever hit the context limits in your AI dev workflow, you're asking your main agent to maybe come up with the tasks, do the work, review the code, write tests, and then update the docs. And in between, it always feels like it's drifting a bit, and you're always fixing and debugging the issues along the way, and it just feels overwhelming. Well, if this sounds familiar, then this video is for you. By the end of this video, you understand how to make a modular agent system that scales and keeps your main agent laser focused using OpenCode. All right, this is what we're looking to create. We're trying to create a primary agent that will handle orchestration and break down tasks and give it to the relevant sub-agents, and then we'll always validate and integrate the results. And each task will be passed to the sub-agents, which will have access to their own needs and understand how to break that individual task for their own context, which will never get pushed back to the main agent. The main agent will only get relevant information back, which keeps that main context aligned when building maybe a very complex project. So we're going to dive into more of that. Now, I want to start off, what are OpenCode agents? Well, you can think of them as specialized agents for individual tasks. They're very context aware for whatever's passed to them, so they're given the relevant context for that task, and it really works well in collaboration. And you kind of want to think of this more of a context-driven architecture result. So you only want to give the agent the relevant context, not too much context. And that will help streamline your workflow and also stop deviations as much as possible in your AI coding. We've got two types of different agents. We've got primary agents and we've got sub-agents. Your primary agent is like the coordinator. It understands the big picture, it breaks down complex tasks and coordinates with the sub-agents. And it has access to the full project context and knows when to delegate. Your sub-agents is more your specialists. For example, you could have a code review agent that understands your code quality, a testing agent to understand your testing procedures, and your documentation agent to know where and how to format your documentation. Each has its focus context and specific expertise. And this just helps mitigate giving too much context to the primary agent there. It gets convoluted and seems to drift the more and more conversations you have. So you kind of want to keep it more laser focused. To set up your agents, it's quite simple. There's two methods. One is using JSON. You can configure it into your opencode.json config file, either locally or per project. And the main things here to notice is your mode is primary, or you can use mode as sub-agent. And you can specify the model, the prompt, and what tools it has access to, if it should use it or not. And this just helps us build the agents very quickly and easily. My preferred way is using Markdown on screen, just because I find it easier to read and edit than using the config, but you can use what you like best. And essentially it is the same. We've got the mode, we've got the model, we've also got temperature, and we've got the tools it has access to. And then of course the prompt. All right, and then the workflow. This is how I like to kind of work with agents, is always I want to try to make sure the plan is in place, then make a task, and generally this will revolve making a .txt, so it actually follows the .txt, and then makes those code changes in that order, makes the code, reviews, tests, and if we're all happy, then it's done and we prepare that for deployment. That's the idea. All right, we're going to start a new project, so there's nothing here. I'm just going to make my open code folder. I'm going to go .opencode. And then in here, I'm going to just make another folder called agent. That's singular, not plural. And then here we can make our core agent if we want, .md. And if you ever stuck to know where to get the configs of the agents, you can just go to the open code and you can go to agents over here. You can click it and just scroll down to Markdown or JSON, whichever you prefer, and you can grab the context here. And there's a lot of different options from temperature, and different models have different options, so you can look into that. Like, for example, OpenAI recent bought in reasoning effect and text verbosity. So that's specific settings for like OpenAI at the moment. Other models might follow pursuit, but just note that's how you can do that. All right, so just going back, if we just want to copy that across. All right, with our settings comp, we actually just want to update this. So we're going to maybe make this the wait. And we will update this. This shouldn't be sub-agent. We actually want to make this primary. And we will just keep it some full. Temperature right is true. And we can just update that. So we've made our agent here, but this is to see if we can get it working in OpenCode. So I'm just going to go Control Escape. I've got the extension to run OpenCode and VS Code. And if I press Tab, you'll see here we've got the core agent already initialized. So it's actually picking up on new agent immediately. But if we press Tab, it'll change to Build and Plan. Build and Plan is the standard agents that OpenCode comes with. So one thing I'm going to do is I'm going to dictate here. So I'm probably going to skip ahead after I've made this prompt so you can follow along. All right. So you'll see here I'm talking about the planning, the task breakdown, and then the implement phase. And then I've got the review phase with the testing. And that's what we covered before. But you'll notice I'm talking about they should use a review testing agent, a core agent, which is this agent. And then we also got the planning phase, which is also using a planning agent. And we don't really have these agents yet. We're just looking at our directory. We've just got agents. So I'm actually just going to create a new folder here called subagent. And in these subagents, I'm just going to create each normal one. So we went to planning agent, and I'm just going to call this planner.md. And we're going to just put this here, and we're just going to update this. All right, so we've got a planner agent. All right, we're back. So we can see here I've made the different agents. I've got the planner agent, the task manager agent. I've got the review and the call. And the one thing is I'm telling it that it needs to use these agents, but it actually doesn't know where it is. So what I'm going to just say here is you can find this agent at, but this is a subagent. And what I found is you kind of want to always give it where it should find it. So I'm just going to sub agent here, and it'll be the task manager MD. And this is quite useful. So it will know where to pick this up because it's in the relative path where it is in the sub agent, and we're using the task manager, and that's where the sub agent is. And now we've referenced our different agents here. So we can see we've got our planner, we've got our task manager, and we've also got our review. All right, we're going to just test these agents. So I'm just going to go Command Escape because I've got the OpenCode extension. And if we actually press Tab here, we will probably see our agents. And actually we can't see them. And the reason why is we can actually come here and we can see this is actually a mode subagent, and this should be primary. And the same with review, because we also want these to be primary. All right, so if we come back here, we can see as the change is not taken, so we're gonna have to exit and restart the session. And if we just restart OpenCode, it says, because I spelled primary wrong. All right, so with the change, we can see reviewers here. And we press Tab, we can see the next one, which is core agent, which is great. And then Tab again, we will go back to build and plan. All right, so let's keep on call. And we can see the sub agents are mode sub agent, so that's why they're not popping down there. And the task agent is sub agent. Maybe we want to change each model for each sub agent. How do we actually go about doing that? Models.dev. And in here, you'll actually see all the models that OpenCode actually uses under the hood. So if you want to find which model to use, you can come here and see. So for example, there's Amazon Bedrock, there is Deep Infra. So we can see there is the Quinn Coder Plus, and I've got the OpenRouter Quinn Coder. So I'm just going to grab that, copy, and then I'm literally going to go back to my code base for the reviewer. I'm going to just use that. And maybe for the planner, instead of the Synthropic, maybe I can use Gemini. So if I want to go back, so we can just type in here, Gemini. And maybe we want to use the 2.5 Flash Gemini here. And it's just Gemini 2.5 Flash. There we go. One thing to note, you have to have the auth signed in for all of these. And if you don't know how to do that, just remember, it is open code, then you go auth and log in. And what you'll see here is it has all the different ones. You can go Anthropic, GitHub, open code, open routers, which is one I was mentioning here, Google for the API keys. But you get the idea. All right, so just going through this. So we've got the Gemini 2.5 Flash for our planner, task management agent. We're just going to use Godsign 4.5, which is fine. And then the core is also Claude sign up. Great. So we've got that. And let's just do a quick example. So if we just run OpenCode now, we should get those updates. So we got the core here, we've got the build, we've got the plan, and we can run it that way. All right. So let's just do a simple plan. This try make a snake game, for example. All right, so we're just going to ask it to make a snake game, and hopefully it should follow the step-by-step workflow that we've given it. So if we just run there, we should see it starting to run. All right, so we can see the user wants to create a snake game. It's trying to read things that aren't there, so it's got nothing to find. And we can see it gave everything to the task agent just to build out the task that it needs to run. And you can see here we can use control right and left. This wasn't working for me the other day, so I had to see if it works. No, still not working for me today. But hopefully when you are installing this and using it, you can use control right and left just to navigate between sub-agents to actually see what's happening in here and can see what prompts they're using. So the plan agent has done a good job. Now it's given to the task agent to start breaking down, and it is making a plan. The first task. All right, I'm going to stop it here, and I kind of want to use this as an example. So we've updated our agents here, and we can see it wasn't really creating the subtask. All right, so we are just making sure we're referencing the planner agent here, so at planner, and then we're also just telling where to find it just in case it loses track. We can also see what agents we have in here, just going /agent to see if the agents are getting picked up. So all right, so I've just updated my core agent, and we're just going to run it again just to make sure it's actually doing what we wanted it to do. And I'm just going to say we want to keep making the snake game. It did some changes, so we'll just see if it actually follows through with that. So it's just reading the files itself. So here it's like using the planning agent to actually evaluate the different state. So the plan agent is validating the whole workspace and getting all the relevant information, and then should hopefully pass this back to the main agent to determine what to actually focus on. So again, you can always just see what agents have been called there. And this is just what's happening in each of these little agents here. Let's use the task manager to break down the implementation step. So it's trying to understand the task, and then the planning agent is going to just read and run each one. All right, it's delegating the next one, which is the task general breakdown the snake game task. So it's doing this route, so it's planning, then it's giving it to the task manager, and then we'll execute the implementation, and then review agent. So you can see how the core agent's kind of following our workflow here. All right, great, we can see it. It's time to execute. It's executing the implementation. It's going to do each of the tasks. Great, we can see it's giving it to the review agent. So I try to do a test, but it failed, so we'll see what the review agent actually does, if it actually writes a test for it to see if it's going to pass. And we can see the review agent's doing its own context. It's just reviewing. We can see the review agent's also doing some tests to see if it's working. We can see it executed each of the agents as we asked it to in terms of our workflow process. And we can even see it how it defines each one. It broke into 17 actionable tasks per three phases and how it validated. And this is have a quick check to see if this actually works as intended. All right, so this is the snake game. It worked. Let's press enter to start. All right, let's see if it breaks. And we can see these are some nice, simple game mechanics. Great. All right, so I hope you see how we went from one overwhelmed agent trying to manage all the different tasks and contexts to actually breaking it down into a team of coordinated agents. And we really focus more on the context management of what each agent should do and how context is passed from one agent to another to streamline our tasks to get better results. I would advise you to definitely try this architecture in your own projects. Please give me a comment down below how you find it. And if there are any questions, please let me know. I'll answer them in the comments down below. And if you like this content, please hit that like and subscribe down below, and I'll see you in the next video. Talking about the next video, I'm actually going to be doing OpenCode plugins, which is how you can actually integrate your OpenCode terminal to external APIs and things like that. So stay tuned for that one, and I'll see you in the next video. Cheers.